Sublime in majesty and might. A good and beautiful morning to you, brothers and sisters. How nice it is to be together again in prayer. Thank you for joining us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 9. Triumphant thanks. O God, I worship you with extended hands as my whole heart explodes with praise.
I will jump for joy and shout in triumph as I sing your song and make music for the Most High God. For when you appear, I worship while all of my enemies run and retreat.
I will tell everyone, everywhere, about your wonderful works and how your marvelous miracles exceed expectations.
O Lord, you will never, no, never neglect those who come to you in need. Listen, everyone. Sing out your praises to the God who lives and rules among us.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 34. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So Umberto was to have our reflection today, but as you know, he is struggling with back pain and waiting to see a specialist early next month. So he asked me to share his gratitude to so many of you that reached out to him in prayer and thoughts. He's hanging in there, good spirits, and I promise I'll keep all of you updated as I know what's going on. So in the meantime, you're stuck with me for the reflection today. So you lose, But my reflection, well, you know what? It begins at 4:51 this morning when I woke from a deep sleep, feeling refreshed and rested in a way that doesn't usually always happen. And as I swung my legs around and sat on the edge of the bed, I could see the squirrels and the birds out my window, scurrying around and hear them singing. And then I caught a reflection of me in the glass, and I was smiling. I mean, of course I was, because I kept thinking to myself sitting there, how blessed am I? Thank you, Jesus. And that's when I felt my arms being lifted, my palms up, and I just said out loud, you are so good to me, Lord. Thank you. May I serve you faithfully this day. So that's me. How about you? What are you thankful for today? Let us surrender our hearts to God now and pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for your presence in our lives, for the strength you give us each day, and for all the gifts, big and small, that remind us of your goodness. Help us to always have a full heart of gratitude and to trust in your perfect plan. We ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As I mentioned yesterday, the days that I lead the God Minute, I'm incorporating a short prayer of belonging that I wrote and pray each day and have for many years. And now I invite you to join me in it as we go our separate ways. You can find it in the day's notes section on the app. So let us pray.
To you do I belong, O God. Into your hands I surrender my life. Pour out your Spirit upon me, that I may love you perfectly and serve you faithfully until my soul rests in you.
And may this God of all goodness and blessing come down upon you now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, brothers and sisters. Thanks again for being with us, and we will see you tomorrow.